Welcome to episode 4 of the PowerShell Jumpstart series. This time we'll go over the ForEach loop. So there are many kinds of loop sequence types. For now, we'll just focus on the ForEach loop. PowerShell has both a ForEach keyword statement, which is really a fancy name for a reserved word, and a ForEach-Object cmdlet, which also happens to use the ForEach word as an alias. This confuses people a lot. For now, don't really think too much about this. We'll go over this subject again in the future, and if you need more information, feel free to reach out, and there's a lot of online material about this if you happen to need it. So just for future reference, try to remember the ForEach keyword loops over arrays without a pipeline, and the ForEach-Object command that processes objects through a pipeline. If you forget about this or you don't understand any of what this means, don't worry about it. You will when the time comes. And for now, PowerShell will take care of everything for us. So let's create a variable named name, and it will store an array of names. Actually, I'll name it names. And it will store the Ninja Turtle names, Leo, Ruff, Mike, and Don. These are not the Renaissance Masters, in case you were wondering. So, let's do the ForEach loop. So ForEach name in names. Now, I'm using the word name here to represent each of these names within the array. You can use any word you want. You can use the word turtle, you know, you can use an underscore, which is what most people use. For now, I'll just stick with name. Then we open up curly braces, and you can run anything you want here, but for this purpose, I'll run a write host message to keep it simple. So name is a ninja turtle. Okay. So I'll run this loop, and it will, you know, iterate through every single name here and add it to my message right here. So Leo is a ninja turtle, Rath is a ninja turtle, Mike and Don are the same. Okay, so we'll go through another way of doing this. Instead of grabbing each name from an array here, I'll just get the content from a file. Get content. So let's go to a file here named turtles.txt. I created this prior. So if I go to ctemp, just create a file same as I have here named turtles.txt, and fill in the names. Each name needs to be separated by a new line. In that way, it will, you know that it's a different string there that it will grab. So it will grab Leo, then Raph, then Mike, and then Don. So that's how the iteration goes. I'll run this bit this time, and it did it. So Leo is a ninja turtle, and so on. Okay, so there's one more way to do this, and this is with the ForEach object cmdlet. So names. I'll just grab the same file to get the contents. So names, pipeline for each object. And I will just do the same right here. To make it a bit different, I'll just add some color. I'll use green because the turtles are green. Okay, so I'll run these two lines and see what happens. Whoops, it didn't grab the names. The reason why is because these variables actually grabbing the, you know, whatever was last from the previous get content variable. So what we're going to do here is actually replace that with a underscore, And in this way, the ForEach object command that will, you know, interpret this as every single object within this text file. So I'll run this again. And it actually grabbed the names. So remember, when you use a ForEach object commandlet, make sure you specify the, you know, each object from within your array or your file as a $ underscore variable. Right. For now, that's it for the for each loop. Thank you.